And it just started to spew coolant. Once that reservoir built up the pressure, it just it couldn't handle it. Come on, guys, let's get this day going. We're gonna go get the truck washed, and then we're gonna start our day and head to Allentown. Should be a good one. I love those trucks. I don't know why, but the 9400i's, good looking trucks. My truck got the new coolant sensor in, so the check engine light should be off, and it's warming up right now. So we're gonna go, double check, make sure. Oil's good, coolant's good, did my pre-trip, and should be ready to roll. Listen to this Detroit purr, if you wanna call it that. No amber glow, look at that. It is nice and clear. We're good, we are good. The driver's seat was in horrible shape, absolutely horrible shape. And I thought about buying a brand new seat, but then I thought to myself, these Freightliner seats are the exact passenger and driver's side. So I just swapped them around. And you can tell this previous passenger seat, this thing is immaculate. I mean, the cushion, it feels like a brand new seat. So it would have been silly to go out and spend a grand on a new seat. But, you know, it looks good. And I put the passenger, the driver's side on, the driver's seat on the passenger side. Nobody ever sits there. But I'm anxious to try this seat out and just see how much better it is, because it's better than that seat ever was. I mean, this thing feels, like I said, brand new. I'm kind of anxious to get on the road and test it out. Yeah, see this cushion right here? On the other seat, on the driver's seat, that was the driver's seat, that was just flat, super flat. So you can kind of see it, a little wrinkly there. Not very supportive. A shame what happened to Celadon for the drivers, not necessarily the company itself, because they screwed themselves. But here at the yard where I parked my truck, we have a bunch of Celadon trucks. Let's see, there's a day cab, some sleepers. They are all sitting vacant, and actually there's a couple more here than there were when I parked earlier. Yeah, they're bringing them here, dropping them off. And I talked to the manager of the shop here, and he was telling me that Celadon still owes them $15,000. I don't know if they can put a mechanics lien on these trucks or not, but they're not gonna get that money. So that's kind of a bummer. Just shows that it's affecting more than just, than just the drivers. It's affecting a lot of people. But anyways, I'm here at the truck, and we're gonna get back on the road. I did not wash the truck yet. I'm gonna try to wash it today. Had a bit of an issue with it so I didn't have time to wash it. But we'll get to it today, I hope. Should be able to. It needs it. Man, look at those wheels. It's been a long time since I've washed it. So we're gonna get that washed. That gas tank over there is filthy. I need to get that severely washed. I think the gas cap was leaking. I just replaced the gas cap. But yeah, the sensor though, that coolant sensor they put in on Friday, it took a crap on me already. The thing, it was an honest mistake on their part, and they made right by it. They reimbursed me for it, but when they put the sensor in, they pinched the little O-ring that goes in there, and it just started to spew coolant. I mean, once that reservoir built up the pressure, it just it couldn't handle it. So it was spewing coolant everywhere. It wasn't good, but it wasn't taking up as much as, you know, it wasn't drinking it too bad. But it ended up getting way worse, and I had to go ahead and just get it fixed at a TA and have them replace it. But I called my shop up though and told them, and they, without even you know, debating it, they were like, okay, well, just, you know, if you got the old part, just bring the old part in, which I did, and they took off the cost of the part and the labor off the bill, so I couldn't complain too much. Plenty fair to me, you know. I used up some coolant, you know, about 2 gallons of coolant to get it to where I had to go to get it fixed, because of course it happened on a Sunday, and it's harder to find somebody to work on something on a Sunday, obviously. But I was able to get it to a TA, and they were able to get it in there pretty quick and get it fixed. But it took 2 gallons of coolant for me to get there, on top of the coolant that they had put in there. So, you know, it went through it pretty quick. But it's good now. It's not leaking any more coolant. It's been behaving just fine. So we're going to get on the road. And yeah, that's why I didn't wash the truck, because I want to get the whole thing washed. And the coolant was coming out so bad, I actually got streaks of coolant on my side fairings, on my steps, because it was coming out of the hood right there where the latch is. it's all good now, though. So I'm just going to go ahead and get it washed and get all that residual crap off of there. So we can get rolling. We're good to go. First time it's been washed in a long time, so she deserved it big time. Replace that with some chrome chicken light strips, maybe. Who knows? It might be in the cards. stopped here at the Flying J in Hubbard, Ohio for my 30. Coming out with a cold, I guess. And so what sounded better to, you know, quench my hunger than some good old chicken noodle soup. So yeah, that's my lunch, my dinner, whatever. And yeah, I got a little sore throat going on, so this stuff really hits the spot here at the Flying J. But we're gonna get back on the road here and finish our jog to Allentown.
I got in a hurry one time. I got further behind, so I gave up on the idea.
They were getting pissy earlier. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and get back on the road. So see you in a little bit. Well, it's the end of the night. I'm getting unloaded right now, and then after this I go to my reload and I'll take my break. But I just wanted to say a little something. You know, this year there's been a lot of companies that have been shutting down. You've got anywhere from your single owner operators all the way up to mega carriers like Celadon. It just kind of shows how trying the trucking industry is right now. I'm not saying there aren't people that are extremely successful still right now, because there are. But you've got to be very strategic about it. And, you know, but now I realize that Celadon, it's not really necessarily about strategy. It's about how, just how crappy their management was. I mean, they're, you know, there's a couple that have been indicted, you know, going to jail because of their deeds. But I had made in a couple Facebook groups, I had posted that if there were any drivers, you know, that did get stranded with Celadon and they were along my route, which is 80 through Pennsylvania down to Allentown, basically back. Sometimes I take 80 back into Ohio to 76, to 71 to Cincinnati. Sometimes I take the toll road, so 78 down to the toll road across to 70 and into Ohio that way. But I had said if there were anybody that, you know, needed any help along that route, I'd be willing to help. And you know, the offer still stands. If there's anybody that needs that help, you know, I'll just try to contact me, contact me anywhere. I guess my Facebook would be the best place to contact me at. And that would be my name. But yeah, so it's a shame, you know. Like I said, it was kind of eerie today when I saw all those Celadon trucks at my yard. Usually when I see those trucks there, they have drivers in them, you know, getting ready to hook up to a trailer and deliver their next load. But today they were just sitting empty, vacant. They were, you know, it's almost kind of like a ghost town in a way, but with trucks, you know what I mean? So, with that said, though, you just got to be smart out here, you know? You just got to be smart about what you do, especially if you are an owner-operator. You really have to be, you have to, you know, look five moves ahead. And especially right now, you know, the rates the way they are, the insurance rates the way they are, especially if you're you know, with your own authority, one wrong move can be the end of it. So you really need to be, well, like I said, strategic about what you're doing. But anyways, now to save myself from the rambling, I'm just going to go ahead and get off here and sign off and finish this this video. I've actually had fun making this video. It's been a while since I've gotten into making a video like this, you know, like just kind of the more just the more like entertaining type of at least to me, the more entertaining type of editing, things like that. So, you know, I got into it a little bit more, so I like that. But anyways, with that said, guys, hope you all stay safe out there, and we will talk to you guys later. Take care, guys.